Hey, I'm at the Dream Center right now, and we're about to go speak to about 80 hungry men, and I'm going to be talking to them about getting a game face on, looking at Judges chapter 7 and 8, as Gideon took on the countenance of a prince. And so Steve and I are here for the first time to begin ministering to these men, and they're taking on the core program. They're excited about spreading it out through the entire Dream Center ministry, as far as also Angel's Temple, and I'm so pumped. God's just going to do a great work here.
Let the walls fall down. Let the walls fall down. Let the walls fall down. By His love, let the walls fall down. Let the walls fall down.
So you were saying you're here for 6 months, and that every day you wake up to war.
Every day is a battle. And that's one thing that that's the only one thing I see here, is that they need more training. I see you're going to do on Gideon. I seen that. I go right on. They need to hear stuff like that.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Kendall Spellman. I'm from a small town in Georgia called Bexley. I went and pursued things that were not Christian. I went to parties throughout high school. I started drinking at the age of 15, and it completely destroyed my life. I hated my life. I wanted to end it. There were 3 times where I tried to commit suicide and end my life because I had no hope and I hated living. And there was an account where I got in a really bad argument and fight, and I went to jail for about 2 months. God has completely restored me. He's gave me hope and love from people and this acceptance that I've never had before. I want to be a missionary when I grow up. I want to help the poor and the hungry, feed the homeless, and anything that's in God's will I want to do, because I surrender my life to His will now.
Rise up, O men of God, have done with lesser things. Give heart and soul and mind and strength, we serve the King of Kings. Rise up, O men of God, His kingdom tarries long. Bring in the day of brotherhood and in the night of wrong.
Tonight, we have a special speaker, and I was at a birthday party for one of my friends, for his daughters, and I met, Harry Beeson, and, Harry, we're talking, and we're, just going over what we do, and when I told him that I'm over the men's ministry at Angel's Temple with the Dream Center, he got excited. He says, there's somebody that you got to meet. He goes, there's somebody that, his name is Art Hobba. And so I was like, well, let's set it up, God is using this man in a mighty way, amen. And that's the message that he carries here tonight, is that if he can do it for him, then he can do it for all of us. Amen. Yeah. So with no further ado, you know, Brother Art Hobba.
Jesus was called to war. He said, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent ones will take it by force.
Yes.
He said, I didn't come to bring peace. I came to bring a sword. Is that the words of some flower-sniffing, limp-wristed, dandelion-skipping guy?
No.
We got a Savior that was a man.
That's right.
And this is the place where Jesus set his face. This is the place Jesus got his game face. And the second Greek word is he was immovable, solid, hard, and rigid. Now, we know that we're not supposed to be rigid and hard men to our wives, to one another. We've kind of learned how to be tough and rigid with one another, and we call that manhood, and it's not manliness.
Yeah.
We're called to love one another as dear brothers. And I sense that here tonight. And God will bring tests, and he's brought tests to your life where you're going to be brought to a place where he's going to say, are you going to go? Is this a go? Or are you going to back out? You going to wuss out?
Come on.
Okay?
Come on. Bring
it. Takes courage, man. Have game face and keep it. And Jesus set his face, and man, he went through it. It says, for the joy that was set before him, he went through it. He's called us to be men like that. Boy, I tell you, the toughest, strongest, most courageous, most inspiring man on planet Earth is a man who's got game face for Jesus. You want to say amen?
Amen.
And it takes a ferocity on our face and an attitude that is totally different. I turn to my wife and I have love, compassion, patience, forgiveness, and leadership, and I'm a servant to her. As best I can be. And by the way, I ain't perfect at that. She'll be, if she was here, she'd go, amen. Okay? So I'll just say it for her. But that's my mission. And men that continue to fall in sin are missing two things. They're missing game face, and they're missing two or three men around them that they love and trust and that know about all their stuff and love them anyway. And they won't betray me. And they're not going to talk about me to other people. They're not going to run to pastor and go, pastor, I have a prayer request. Mikey over there is doing weird things in the dark. Okay? All right? How many men here tonight, and this is not a, I'm not counting, but how many men here tonight know in their hearts that they are a son of the Father in heaven? They're an adopted son of the Father. Your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. If you're a son of the Father, you're a prince. There's a phrase that they use. No man left behind. What if the church operated on that code? If you're here tonight, you need to ask yourself those questions. Am I a boy that shaves? I'm a man. The world will teach you how to be a man. Go watch Jackass 2. Find out what testosterone looks like. Okay? They have a substitute for masculinity. If you're here and this is your first opportunity to really come clean and say, God, I'm your man, why don't you just lift your hand? Is that why you're looking at me, son? I agree with you. God wraps his arms around you and adopts you as his beloved son. Thank you for the many men who have gained a new countenance, the countenance of a prince. And we thank you, Lord, that that comes from you to your glory. Amen.
Amen. Amen.